Welcome to video number 15 on working with train controller. In the previous video we modified the user interface to our liking, and in the end of that video we clustered the four throttle windows that we had in a nicely aligned and grouped cluster. Those throttle windows can be highly customized themselves, and let's have a look in this video how we can do that. Here's our four throttle cluster. Why do I have four? Well, that was because I had four engines. But suppose if you have 20 engines, it has no use to have 20 throttles in view. It will even be impossible or much too cluttered interface. It's totally up to you how many throttles you create. Zero is also possible if you have only automated traffic. And one or two is maybe the least you would like to have a few trains drive manually. You can always select which train is controlled by clicking the bar and then select an engine from the list. Or alternatively, you can double click in the train list and it will activate in one of the throttles. Let's see how we can modify the throttle. For that we go to the window menu to create a new one, a new train window. Here it is. Let me simply enlarge that a bit so we can have a better look. And let me also change this now to a steam engine, because that makes available these nice icon graphs over here about how much water and how much coal I still have available. It's nice operation. If you drive long distances, this water and coal will of course become lower and lower, and at a certain point you will need to replenish them or you cannot drive further. That's there just for fun. It can be nice to play with. By the way, these two circles over here, they depict the signals that are ahead of us, but they only work in operations mode. That's why in edit mode they are gray. So the throttle already is quite a nice thing to use. It gives a lot of information, but it can be highly changed. And that is done by going to the view menu and then train window customize. And over here we have the general tab, and we can show the train image or show the train name. Well, that sounds simple. Let's change that to name and let's click preview. And all of a sudden now we see here the name instead of the image. By the way, when I created these engines, I used the DCC address for the name, just for the sake of time. But of course you can give it any name, any text that you like. Then the second line over here is about maximum width and maximum height. That talks about this gouge. This window can be resized, but at a certain moment your gouge will not grow larger than the numbers that you gave yourself over here. Then we have the throttle, the brake and the functions. That's about this area over here. This is the throttle and this is the brake. And yeah, we can tell over here in these drop downs how they should show. Well, personally I always put them on dynamic, which means they grow with the size of the window, or shrink of course. Why do I not yet see any function buttons? Well, that simply is because when we created the engines we did not tell it that it has decoder functions available. So let's first do that. But to do that we need to get out of this properties window and get into the train properties window by double clicking. And there we have several tabs, and one of them is called the functions tab. And over there we can add a new function. And then from this drop down list we can select from the default available functions. Well, let's select a headlight, and that is function number 0 usually, that's correct. But I can change that over here if I would like. And also if you have a function that is not available yet in this list, then please go here to the library where you can add a new function yourself. That is outside of the scope of this video, so there will be a later video about how to do that and also how to change these icons over here. For now, we have enough with this little light function that we now have, and let's close this properties window. And yes, we see already over here that a function button is added, and if I click it, it gets its on color, and if I click it again, it is off again. So that seems to work. Now back to the properties window to customize that. What I can do if for instance I never use the break, and personally indeed I never use that, I could take it out to declutter this window a little bit. And let's go to this break drop down for that and simply make it invisible, and then click the preview window, and now the break is gone. Well, I like that. Because I never use it. So this is all a personal preference, of course. These two, this area here, I'm going to skip. You can try out yourself what it does. It is not really an important function. Let's go to the throttle tab, and over here we have the steps of the throttle. Personally, I always put it on decoder steps. My decoders have 28 steps, which now means that my throttle uses those 28 steps. But it can be changed. Something interesting can even be done with it. Suppose that I put it on 4 steps. We will see in a minute how that works out. The brake can also you can also choose the amount of steps, but yeah, I deleted the brake, so that will not work. Over here there is a show button possibility. I click it on and let's preview that, and all of a sudden we have 2 buttons over here that will increment or decrement the steps, the speed steps. Also we can put on the show 0 button. Let's do that and let's preview that, and that does not yet show, but in a minute we will see how that turns out. Then I'm also going to change over here the null position is now centered. I like the zero position to be at the left and the direction to be train oriented versus direction layout oriented. The difference is layout oriented means if you are standing at the south side of your layout looking to the north, then this arrow here says left or right looking at your layout. But that confuses me always a little bit. I rather look at the direction of the train itself. That also is maybe something to just experiment with and see what you like best. Okay, while we are at it, let's also have a look at this one. The throttle controls the speed, that's the default, but you could change that to throttle controls the power, which now means that if you slide the slider, it increases the engine power, and it depends, let's say, on the physics and the mass and whatever, some interesting hidden calculations, what the resulting speed of your engine will be. It is more prototypical this way, but also it takes a little bit getting used to, especially if you are doing very fine shunting operations. Maybe it's more direct to use the speed setting, and that is what I personally always use. Well, let's see how this worked out, and let's especially see these 4 throttle steps that we now have over here, what that means. Let's hit OK, and now we are in operation mode more or less. I should have slider 0 position at the left. Yes, that is correct, because here at the left it is 0 and here it is maximum. And we see that with the slider I can still have full linear precise control. But I said I had only 4 speed steps. Well, that is now what these increment and decrement buttons do. You see that it immediately jumps to 40, and then there, and then there, and then there. So I indeed only have 4 speed steps, and it can be interesting to use it this way. You still have the slider for precise control, but you have now these speed steps for a few interesting intermediate positions. So yeah, that that can be quite an interesting way of using it. By the way, you do not always have to click these buttons over here. You can also use the left and right arrow buttons on the keyboard, like I'm doing now. Click, click, click. So yeah, it can be interesting to have a limited amount of speed steps for the increments and still have a linear control available with your slider. At least that is how it looks. I hope that it also works that way. I never tried it so far. I should do that. Okay, let's go back to the properties window. That is train window customize, and let's see what more we can do over here. Well, the rest that we can do is more or less all cosmetics. We can go to the speedometer tab. And there we see a lot of colors that we can change. Let's, for instance, change the border color to silver. Yeah, that worked, and it is now silver. Let's change the style of the pointer to style 5. Yeah, that changed the style. Well, it's just to try out what you like. All these sliders do something, like the angle slider. That's interesting. It changes your gouge, and well, you can just create what you like personally. And the interesting thing on this tab is this one, the sensitive click box or checkbox. That says that now my gouge over here is mouse click sensitive, which means if I would click here on 60. In operation mode, of course, then this green pointer will automatically jump to 60 and my train will accelerate to 60. So personally, I always set this tick mark here to sensitive so that I can click on my gouge. That is just quite convenient. The rest is just trial and error. Just see what you can do and see what you like. The same holds for the odometer tab. That is about this counter over here. Let me change the position, for instance, here to the bottom. This counter, you can change all kinds of colors and sizes. It's just what you like. Well, that was it about the throttle window. I did not even think I told everything, but well, of course, you can experiment just with it and see what results you like best. The next video will be about speed profiling, which is an interesting and important function. We have now this gouge over here, and if I click 40, yeah, what does that mean? Well, hopefully it means that my scale speed then becomes 40 kilometers per hour. But how does train controller know that? Well, it doesn't. We first have to do some measurements to tell it exactly for every speed step what the measured speed of the engine is, and only then this gouge will be any accurate. And more important even, we told in the block sensors that we would like to have a brake distance of, let's say, 80 centimeters and a stop distance of 85 centimeters. How does train controller know when it has traveled exactly that amount of centimeters? Well, it only knows if you have accurately speed calibrated engines. And that's what we are going to do in the next video. Thank you for watching. Maybe see you back there. Bye bye.